And another thing, see, that's what they used to say, you know, when growing up in my household, my mom and them, you know, mom and them, that's what we used to say, mom and them, your mom and them, they start arguing with you, and you already know, hey, you ain't gonna let you off the hook. When they get on the roll, you know, you think it's about to be over, and she'd turn around, you know what, and another thing, I mean, not another thing, well, I got another thing I almost forgot about. I know I made about 4 or 5 videos today, but of course, Kevin's Corner, you never know what's gonna happen. Sometimes I freestyle it. Sometimes I just throw on the mic. I'm like, give me a beat, grab the mic, and just start busting rhymes, right? I almost forgot that I wanna fight Captain America. That's right, I'm calling him out. I wanna go one-on-one with Captain America. I guess what his real name is, Chris somebody, I'm not sure, the guy who plays Captain America in the Avengers now. I love the Avengers. Love them to death. Love the Hulk. Love all of them, you know. But once again, people from Hollywood getting political, stepping out there. And you know what? Here's my thing. If you disagree with Kanye West, you don't have to belittle the man's intelligence. And see, this is the problem with the left, okay? With radical left people. Instead of saying, you know what, let me take a second to try to get an understanding of where this man is coming from, because, you know, if you didn't know, Kanye West was on Saturday Night Live, which now have become just a propaganda piece, along with all that rest of the late night TV shows. I used to love Jimmy Fallon. Used to love him. You know, Jimmy Kimmel, but Jimmy Fallon, hilarious. Might still watch him every blue moon. But, I mean, it's just, it's pathetic what they're doing to late night TV, all trying to win brownie points for the left. But nonetheless, Kanye West is on SNL, and I guess they didn't want him to go out with his MAGA hat, you know? I mean, it's one of those things like, you're gonna go out in that? You know, I mean, you sure? I wouldn't advise it. You know, I think you should just go ahead and leave it back here. Let people just focus on you, Kanye. We don't want people to really get distracted by the MAGA hat. Let's just focus on you. And I'm sure in the back, they probably put the pressure on him or whatever, but afterwards, he got up and he spoke up and he said, you know, he came out with the hat, and I heard the audience booed, but then I heard also some of them, after he stated what he was stating, talking about how they tried to bully him in the back, but they can't control him, they can't do that, and he's a free thinker, then some of them start to clap. But Captain America, see, Captain decide he's going to get on Twitter and say Kanye West, I guess, doesn't read books, he doesn't know his history, he's ignorant to all these things. How do you know? How you know that, man? I just don't understand. I guess since he's not an actor, maybe he's just a rapper who, you know, who busts rhymes, you know what I'm saying? Maybe he just don't know what he's talking about, yo. See, this is the assassination of the left when it comes down to minorities dropping this overcoat of victimhood and racism and all of this stuff. That's what they do. They say, you know what we're gonna do? We're going to undermine your message, your independency, by simply saying either you're crazy, which they're trying to do that, or you're simply ignorant and uneducated. Mm-hmm. And if they can't do that, and they realize, uh-oh, I'm dealing with a smart one, I'm dealing with a live one right here, he talks and uses the King's English. Hello, I do say. Allow me to have a chat with you, if you will. Let's discuss all of the narratives that's being preached around the United States, perhaps. I'd like to deduce a conclusion, if you don't mind. Yeah, when they sense that, they're like, uh-oh, he speaks with the King's English. Then what happens is they just simply say, well, you know what? This ain't even a real black person. What are they, counterfeit? You know, I mean, I'm pretty sure that if you dropped off a very intelligent, conservative black person in the middle of a Klan's meeting, they will recognize that it's a black person. I'm not, I guess maybe just because you might speak with the King's English or be conservative, the Klan would just overlook that. Does that cloak you? I mean, does your conservatism cloak you from being black? You know, you just walk amongst the Klan members and they like, how are you? You like, I'm fine, thank you very much. Yep, see Earl, he's not like the rest. That right there, he's conservative. Yep. Intelligent too, all of that stuff. I guess that just cloaks you. So they try to say, well, you know, they ain't real black people and so on and so forth. So they're trying to throw us in categories when it comes down to keeping black and minority people on the Democratic plantation. So as soon as they stand up for themselves, speak out, you get people like Captain America here who comes out and says, well, this guy's ignorant. You know, this guy doesn't know his history. I guess you do, Captain. I mean, don't get caught up in the movie, man. In the movie, yeah, you know, you lived back in, you know, World War II and all. That was a long time ago. But, you know, you're not the real Captain America. You don't have that history behind you, okay? So unless you are educated on black history, black culture, perhaps even, unless you know how the black inner city and the black culture has been decimated by the Democratic Party, manipulated by the Democratic Party, abused by the Democratic Party, allowed to be manipulated by the Democratic Party, putting black leaders that have sold out to the Democratic Party to govern us and convince us that the plantation here is good. Unless you know something about that, unless you know something about puffer puffer rice and bologna, unless you know something about, instead of using a stopper for your tub, you have to put a rag in it. Unless you know something about not even having a screen in your screen door. Unless you know something about no air condition, which you do, open that bad boy up, throw a fan up in there. Yeah, unless you know something about that, unless you know something about that big block of government cheese, you know what I'm saying? What are you talking about? You don't know, yo. I don't even need to know all of the history of black people. I can see what's going on in the black community right now, before my eyes. When I see the Democrats get up there and race bait, and the Democrats get up there and promise black people change is coming and nothing comes, and scare them to go down to the polls and continue to vote for them. When I see the Democratic Party keep contributing to poverty by keeping the ghetto, when I see that stuff, I don't need to know about slavery and all of that stuff. I'm talking about the modern day slavery that's going on right now, Captain, okay? Which is the Democrats just exchanged the cotton fields for the voting booth. That's all they did, Captain. And then they put a couple of their people right in place and said, now you keep your people in line. You understand that? If they start getting on TV and saying stuff that doesn't sound right. Now look, we've embraced you almost, didn't we? We let you come up here. We let you sit at the table with us. What do you want it for? All you got to do is just keep them in line, okay? Don't make us have to do it. Keep them in line. And then you get your Al Sharptons, you get the Jesse Jacksons, you get your Kamala Harris's, yeah. Then you get your Cory Bookers and your Keith Ellisons, and you get all of them to get up there. You get your Don Lemon heads. You get all of them to get up on TV and spew out that garbage to make us walk around like, soon I will be done the troubles of the world. Singing old slave spirituals, rocking my soul in the beloved of Abraham. Yeah, you know, nobody knows the troubles I see. See, Rado, see. All of that stuff. Got us walking around doing that every single day. Yeah, keeping us on the plantation and ignorant to the manipulation of the Democrats. I see that. So I don't need to see the history, Captain. So if you want to debate about it, come on down to the hood. We can meet in the inner city of Youngstown. Take a little walk around if you want to be a hero. Rescue the little black kids that's living in the inner city right there, okay? All right, let's go rescue them. How about this, Captain? You're bulletproof, right? You got your shield? Let's go to Chicago, okay? And look at how the democratically ran city has been decimated by the Democrats, okay? All those black kids, okay? That's not history, that's right now. So, don't need to know about, well, what happened in slavery? No. I'm seeing what's happening right now. So let's go, Captain. I'm ready. I got my shield. Where's yours? Let's do it. I'm like, come on, I want a shot at the title, Captain. Anyway, make me mad. Read about that and was offended. Like, who this cat? You know what I'm saying? I'm not even a big Kanye West fan. As far as the music, he got a couple cuts I like, but you can't just go in and throw the dude under the bus like that, call this man ignorant. That's some bull crap. See? Made Kevin from Kevin's Corner get out of his character. I don't like to get out of my character, y'all. I like to keep it cool, calm, and collective. But he brought this on himself, Captain. Anyway, find me on Facebook. Find me on Twitter. Check me out Wednesday nights at 7:30 in Kevin's Corner. Live radio blog talk show. If you want to support Kevin and Kevin's Corner, there's links in the bottom to do so. Go ahead and, hit like, hit share, and hit the notification button. And we will see you next time in Kevin's Corner. And don't forget to check out Extreme Tees, okay? My sponsor. See my B-boy stance? Y'all know nothing about that. Word. Okay? My sponsor. They got all types of t-shirts. shapes, sizes, so on and so forth. All right? See you next time in Kevin's Corner. God bless. And see you on the streets, Captain America. Or should I say anti-America?